Hey, Peter, Gregg, Miami, Florida. Welcome, welcome to the Christmas room.
Sit back, relax. You are about to watch a Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg.
Hi, welcome, welcome, welcome. Okay, you know, it's Saturday morning. I have to be quiet. Everybody sound asleep. Shh. I've been thinking about the 90D, and I've been trying to come up with a formula, you know, like 1 plus 1 equals 2. So I'm watching what Canon is doing, and there's little things being leaked, but nothing of substance. I mean, there's really nothing we know about the 90D. Nothing at all. They might not even announce a 90D. Nobody promised anything. However, we've taken it upon ourselves that they are. What Canon did say, and to their credit, is from very high up officials, they said they want to focus full steam ahead on the mirrorless market. So that is something that out of their mouth, they said. We could take that to the bank that they said it. But in those same sentences, they also said, you're not going to get at the M50 level what the 5D Mark IV has. Do you think that we're going to give you that? So that means they also are in tune with the pricing and what they're going to give at different price levels. So I've been doing some thinking. What would Canon do with a 90D? They've already promised that they're going to come out with a full frame camera. Even Jingles is not up yet. Jingles, you awake? Come here, baby. So they're going to come out with a full frame mirrorless camera. So what's going to happen with the 90D? Well, I think we got a few clues to look at. I really do. I think that the M50 that they just released is basically the pattern that's going to be for the cameras that are going to be coming out of Canon. So what exactly is this pattern? Well, at $780, Canon figured that we don't deserve to have all the features of a 5D Mark IV, and they've said that. So that's not something to hammer them with. That's just a fact. That's out there. It's in the air. Once you say something on the internet, it's not yours anymore, baby. It's the internet's. You try to protect it, but it won't do you no good. Okay, so they said you can't have a 5D Mark IV for $780. A little bit sassy, right? But at the same time, they do have to protect what they've got. So what do you think they're going to do? I think that the M50 has laid out the floor plan. I think the map has been laid out. I think they're going to come out with a full-frame camera, mirrorless, just like they said. It's probably going to be concentrating on being a little bit smaller, like the Sony, which is a little too small for my taste, but let's see what Canon does. And I think it will probably have 4K, but here's the gotcha. I think they're going to use 4K to throttle or meter the price points. So at $780, which is the M50, they're going to give you 4K. It's going to have a crop of 2.56. So instead of the 1.6 crop, it's going to be 2.56. So how did I get the 2.56 crop? Well, the M50 uses a sensor that's similar to the 80D, 24 megapixels, so on and so forth. And this is a 1.6 crop, okay? So the M50 is a 1.6 crop camera for stills. Or when you go to 1080, it's still a 1.6 crop. That means a 100 millimeter lens is 160 millimeters. We can use something that's easy to do the math, okay? Now, when you turn on 4K, it's another 1.6 crop. So a 160 millimeter lens times another 1.6 is 2.56. So the crop is 2.56 on an APS, or the crop mode sensor, which is on the 80D. We'll take the 5D Mark IV, and that's got a 1.74 crop. So the crops are similar, very close to each other. One's a 1.6, the other one is a full frame 1.74. I think that's going to stay. Honestly, I think that it doesn't matter to the mass market. Let's say they come out with a 90D with 4K. I think it's going to have a 2.56 crop. I think they're going to do the same thing there that they've done in the M50. However, because they're using the 5K and the abilities, 4K, I'm sorry, I misspoke. They're not giving us 5K. Don't get excited, okay? I know it's Saturday morning and you're still dreaming. But I think they're going to use the 4K feature to throttle it up, 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 and up. So I think we're going to get into kind of like a sliding scale, and we're going to get up to the 90D, and we're going to have the same crop, that the 80D has, and I think we're going to have the same crop when you go to 4K that the M50 has. So you're going to also get dual pixel focus is the only area that I can see where they're going to make the 90D different from the lower priced one cameras, because they've got the M50. Who knows what they're going to do with the M6, the M5? My guess is Canon feels if the more cameras they got out there, the more chances are they're going to snag a customer. So the M5 and M6 is going to stay. It's going to stay put. What you're going to get is the M50, which is out, and you're probably going to get an M60. And that's going to probably add maybe a couple of more things. Will they add dual pixel focus to the M60? Probably not. How about the 77D? I don't know. I really don't. But I don't think they're going to put a lot of effort into those cameras. I think they're going to put more effort into the M50 and the M60 and maybe make an M70, because they're going to move us over into the mirrorless cameras. So when they do their big camera, which they did promise, right, the full frame, chances are it's going to be a full frame camera, kind of like the 6D or the 5D Mark IV, and it's probably going to have a crop just like the 5D Mark IV, a 1.74, something in that area. They're going to crop, more crop, less crop. No dual pixel focus, spend more money, we'll add dual pixel focus. You get to this new mirrorless, who knows, it might be a mate to the 5D Mark IV, so it might be the 5M, you know, so maybe on that one, they might put an articulating screen, but still give you the 1.74 crop in a mirrorless body. Hey, most people are going to think that's what we've been looking for. Do you think that they're going to care that it's a 2.56 crop? Most people won't. A chunk of the market will. Okay, don't get me wrong. I'm that chunk, which is why I ordered the A7 Mark III. This is an A9 that we're watching, by the way. And I have to do my thing for the white balance. I'll have to find it in the middle. So what I do is I tap on this with the eyedropper and I white balance. That's it. Done. One and done. So that's called a better white balance. It's in the description below, the link to it. So anyway, the 5M, I don't know if they'll call it the 5M Mark IV, or just start with a 5M, and then start 5M Mark II, 5M Mark III. I don't know how they're going to run it. So the bigger question is, where do we start to get a little bit less than a 1.74 crop? My guess is going to be the 1DX Mark III. I think the 1DX Mark III is going to maintain a Super 35. Nope, they're not going to go full frame. This is my guess. Now, I'm only putting my bets on the table because they have a C700. And you heard that Canon is protective. They said blatantly that we're not going to give you for $780 the same thing we gave you in the 5D Mark IV. I mean, that's right up and in my face. They said it to me, okay? It's in the interview at DP Review. So I'm thinking the same thing's going to happen. We're going to get full frame, and we're probably going to have two or three levels of full frame mirrorless, giving us a little bit more. The M50 is the first mirrorless, okay? And we got a lot less, all right? You got the 2.56 crop, and you get no dual pixel focus. So I think at the other end is going to be the 1DX Mark III. Chances are we're going to get, in that one is my guess, thinking like Canon thinks, we're going to get a new 4K codec in there that's not so heavy. Maybe it will also maintain the MJPEG because that is a very high quality. It's just very cumbersome to work with. Where their C700 doesn't give you MJPEG, they give you ProRes. Now, ProRes is an all-eye, very high quality, that beats the crap out of the AMJPEG because it compresses and it does it beautifully and gives you super amazing quality. It never hits the H.264 compression. So I'm thinking that the 1DX Mark III is going to still be a big camera. They're going to add 4K, probably not make any changes to the body. This is going to be like gravy to them. It's going to be the same sensor. They're going to put 4K in there. They're going to still keep it Super 35, give a better codec. Should probably not put an articulating screen, although I think it's a big mistake. But I do think that the articulating screens are going to happen in the mirrorless. The articulating screen is very important, and the reason that it's important is first you could flip it around, and for the video guys you could see, right? You could see what's going on there. But for pictures, which Canon is focusing on pictures, you know, if you want to get low, you can turn the screen like this and you can take the camera to the ground without you having to go to the ground, maybe down to the knee. But how about if you want to go into that orientation? Okay, with an articulating screen, you've got it. It's right there. And that's very, very necessary. And another thing that's very necessary is the silent shutter. Pastors, ministers, priests have been waking up to the fact that there's cameras that shoot silently. So some of them, and I have run across two, don't want any shutter sounds during the service. No shutter sounds. So if you've got a Canon, a higher-end Canon, you're going to need to shoot right now 4K and extract out of the MJPEG full-frame pictures, or you're going to have to buy a Sony camera or a Panasonic camera because they don't want sounds. Now, that's just two, okay? That's not the majority of them, but they are waking up to that fact. So that's what I think is going to happen with the 90D. I think we're going to get the balance of dual pixel focus with a cropped 2.56 like the M50. That's what I think is going to happen with that. They're going to basically use the same 80D body, and all their development money is going in the mirrorless, which is probably going to start at $2,500 and up is my guess. And we're going to have to see how much of the good stuff they put in. Obviously, at the M50, which is a mirrorless camera, they're not giving us very much. So when they go to full frame, the lower end model, chances are they're not going to give us very much. But as you start to spend more and more money, I think that's where the development is going to be coming in. And one good thing I could say about Canon is they make a really good camera. For a photographer, it just works. You can tell by operating the camera, just by the feel of the camera, it's a camera. I hope they don't make the mistake of trying to be Sony and make everything so tiny, because mirrorless doesn't always mean just tiny. It means they took the mirror out. Panasonic does a very good job of balancing size with mirrorless. I wish this was a full frame, said Canon on there, with all the features that are in here, plus dual pixel focus. That's what would make me happy. So that's what I think is going to happen with the 90D. Now, how about the time frame? It all depends on how much Sony bites into the wallet of Canon. Now, the new things just came out that said Canon has got more than 50% of the market share. So it hasn't been bitten yet. If they feel they're going to get bitten, I think they're going to move. The other thing is Nikon said, we're coming in too. Make room in the pool. So let's see what Nikon does. Are they going to pay any attention to the video side or just put it in like a little bit of seasoning, which is what they've been doing now? So another area that I think Canon could be spending a little bit of marketing dollars is in the lower cinema line, like the C100. There's people that would actually consider it today, but they would really prefer the mirrorless. And I think Canon knows that. And I think the mirrorless is going to be the spearhead for Canon at this point, because they pretty much said that. And I think the 90D is going to get combed over. You notice they don't take stuff off of the market. It just stays out there. And that's how they manage to get these sales being made at the registers. There's just so much stuff all over the world, and they just keep adding to it. So that's what's been happening with that. So that's Saturday with Peter. Thank you for spending a little time with me. I appreciate it. Have a good one. Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Bye-bye. Whoosh.
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching. Description of all equipment used in this video plus any notes Peter took while filming are always placed in the description box, show more box, or down arrow thingy next to the title on mobile apps. Duly noted.